Ray Give TV exclusive. Yo, Ping Ray in here, bro.
He just popped in.
There it go. Somebody must have told him.
It's Ray Give TV.
Oh, you didn't know? I got the content. Click that bell. Tune in. Okay, so check it out. WAC 100 speaks on Brick Baby talking way too much and how they can settle it and meet up at No Jumper and get to it. What? I'll give a shout out to WAC 100, the whole 100 side, spin the block. Let's get to the content.
It's Ray Give TV.
Told you gonna be on No Jumper Thursday. What time you gonna be there, my nigga? So I was on you. He said, bro, you in the trick bag. Them 60s was with him the whole weekend. So we like, that's WAC 100, bro. Who we get into it with? He said, we said, well, who do you have a fight with? I was just here. You heard what? Where? Where was he at? Everybody know that a bunch of spotted him because I was getting calls. Everybody know that, bro. So what you? Nah, I was just trying to get a react. Well, you got a reaction out of him. Now you telling you to put that on the hood and you on mute. You looking crazy. You from the hood, so you making it look like this what we do is Crips.
Yeah.
And now they violated your family and told you to pull up to where you work, where he gonna be. So nigga, he said, you know, oh man, we ain't supporting that shit, bro. Do what you do. He said, now he got his ass to you. What's up with this arrest? You got arrested? Yeah. You been to court? Man, I just gotta holler at you. Now he said, I gotta holler. Nah, you got caught with a K. The feds picked it up. See, this what didn't happen. You go playing with WAC 9 and woke some other shit up that you thought I didn't know.
Wait, man, this cat had a K and the feds picked it up. How long
man, they arrested that nigga June 23rd. The next day, he lied to everybody, said it was a LAPD pickup. Kind of find out it was a Fed pickup. See, this is how we knew Big U was going to get arrested because he tore off 600. Yo, man, they was questioning about Big U, saying they finna hit him with a RICO. They gonna say they gonna pick him up in a month or so. And they put 600 told me, I said, look, bro, either that happened or he working. Why would the LAPD tell him the feds gonna pick Big U up in a month, right? We couldn't put it together. Then come to find out when Big U get picked up the month later, Big U go quiet. The neighbors tell us, yo, the FBI flag jacks in that house 5:36 in the morning. Took him his wife up out of there, right? He said 3 days later they come back, right? I'm like, bro, so Brick Baby wasn't lying, but why would the LAPD blow the whistle on the feds? Uh-oh, bingo, we checking the system. Brick Baby got picked up by the feds, not the LAPD. Why you lying? Big U denying he got picked up. We know you lying. But now he hear me talking about, nigga, the grand jury, your shit just got kicked up to the grand jury, 50 pages. Now we telling niggas, oh man, why I kind of do, kind of. They like my nigga, WAC is eating you niggas up, bro. All you want, you didn't have a BlackBerry, put up the video with the BlackBerry footage, the paperwork showing. You got a partnership with the LAPD. You telling us it's a pop warner. This shit saying you got to turn in guns, report hot spots. And gang violence and all this shit, he's showing the contract.
I seen that one.
Raises and all this. Y'all saying this nigga, he said, bro, show us something with this nigga lying, bro, because he got you looking crazy. Y'all looking crazy.
I think it was a fact, like, when Loose Cannon reached out to his legal team.
It's Ray Give TV.
In the block.
And when that lady said program, that shit was enough for me. Right then and there.
They were so much in denial, they tried to say that video of Big U holding a BlackBerry was a wallet.
No. If you look at the list,
you can see it's a BlackBerry.
If you look at the whole YouTube on that, you see him answering the phone.
Like, what's he doing? Answering his
answers
wallet?
The phone. Yo, do you know how long I've been having that footage? See, I know the nigga. See, all this old stigma of the world, you just sat in my living room, nervous, shaking, asking me for help. I know you, nigga. I know you. You ain't like that. You a brawler fighter. You ain't with none of that other shit. Now them Loose Cannons and all them niggas, members of niggas with that shit. This is why he won't say nothing about Loose or Rosé, because he know what they do. It's him that, man, y'all whack. Yeah, we always whack. What you mean? You was whack. You know why you fell out with whack? You tried to backdoor whack, and whack wasn't going for it. Everybody else scared of you. Whack ain't scared of you. We know why whack ain't scared of you, because you go to whack for help for everything. Finances, street shit, all kind of shit you cutting me for, nigga. And setting this backyard right here, nigga, Nipsey head off. Called him all kind of shit. That's why when I be like, your brother, little brother, hold up, nigga, what's going on? Like, I know what I know. Now, the haters, they gon' always go against me. But niggas with a brain is going to say, hey, bro, everything this nigga done put on the table that these niggas lie about, it come to be. Now, remember I told y'all this, in the next month or two, watch you hear that nigga been indicted to the feds and he been claiming ain't nothing going on. Watch, remember I told y'all. Then you gotta ask yourself, well, nigga, that happened in August. You been lying. How you get out? No ankle monitor. And what you been doing while you been out?
Uh-oh. Cold bust.
I've been running a ring and my nigga brought me a bag, a free bag with World Star. They shaking like dime knots over there. You really let this nigga convince you to go have you jeopardize your partnership with World Star and put this shit up, thinking you gonna troll me, knowing how I'ma play it. You know I got them boys in Beverly Hills at that law firm on retainer. You know I send them people 80, 100,000 a year, every year, just to keep a retainer. You know this is why you sent me the Nipsey contracts, because you know I got a legal team that's a monster. Nigga, you know I'm finna over World Star.
Didn't they make up like some fake documents, a Google fake documents to try to make that. It
this
make
they
sense?
Back. They did all that, and then the nigga Duke Sims, yo, big, we got you back on Clubhouse. We bigger than Wack. They just said, well, Wack, you said the nigga Duke Sims told him he got more control to your Clubhouse, big you, big. He's not a smart guy at all. If you listen to him talk, he says a bunch of shit that don't make sense, that don't even fit with what he's saying, and he lies. Once he get under pressure, he get to repeat himself, and he's gonna lie. I know the nigga. We ran 17 years. I know this man.
It's Ray Give TV.
I know shit about him his neighborhood don't know, because he don't trust his neighborhood, so who you think he came to? The Power Room. I know this man. So that's why I said, oh, yeah, he coming to Clubhouse. We got him now. He finally came. I've been waiting on this. Just let the nigga talk.
Yo, Rap 100, this is Fluffy Combs of the Bloody Bunch. This is Fluffy Combs from the Bloody Bunch. You
bro,
you have to pay
that
shut
later.
Up, you
later. Not right now. God damn. Hey, men like you, y'all got to stop.
They don't never sleep.
That is a form of being, bro, to come at a man that you don't know and just want to scream. Like, nigga, if you want to talk, we had a conversation. That shit is just weird, right? So now he lies, tells you, says it, said that, and the nigga Deuce Hills got him to put that clip up on World Star. Now, I won't sue a street nigga. We gonna deal with it in the street. Ritz Carlton, World Star, Carl's Jr., Delta Airlines, I sue the shit out of them niggas. No problem.
Man, but that shit that Loose Cannon said about him getting the
oh, I got it on my phone.
Nipsey.
I have it on me. Okay, now watch this. You heard Big U say he ain't never been on the FaceTime with Loose Cannon, right?
Right.
Okay. It's on my phone. He just straight, like, looking at this shit. Like, that's why I'm like, boy, you better stop lying. See, he just think niggas don't got what they say they got. Because every day he go home, he deletes all his messages. He got caught cheating like 8 years ago. So soon before he stepped in the house, he deletes his whole message. He don't never got nothing. Everybody ain't operating like that. Now, I don't know, you know, shit. Who's got what he got? You know what I'm saying? He got what he got. He got it. I seen it. I wouldn't let the nigga talk about it if I didn't see it. He just stringing the people along. He picked up 50,000 subscribers just off his first episode. You know, made him a nice little piece of money. What he did was put up the cease and desist that he had the attorney serve him, and then I had Luce call in. I recorded the recording, so we put that up. But here go the thing: if it don't exist, why you sending a cease and desist? If it don't exist, why you sending it? And what the fuck? I thought it didn't exist. No, it'll be on the next episode. He know it's there. He know what he called and told that man. And niggas keep saying, oh, Loose snitching. He ain't snitching. This ain't no criminal shit. He's saying, stop calling Nipsey your brother. You heard the nigga got, you said he was, your first call should have been to his, to him, like mine was when you told me. Only when I called, he was still alive. 30 minutes later, that meant if you knew some harm was going to come to him, and this supposed to be your brother, why you wouldn't call? We ain't saying you sent the nigga, but you heard something. Why you didn't call him to give him warning? You didn't sit in my backyard and called him all kind of snitches. Just whack. I got the paperwork, all the shit on my phone where you wanted me to go at the old estate 30, 40 days after he was dead. Like, nigga, you know you's a fraud, you's a fraud. So that's Loose Cannon thing. Like, no, bro, stop calling the nigga your brother. Nigga, if a nigga told you something was gonna happen, why you wouldn't call to alert him to get out of there? Or if you heard something happen to him, call him to check. Oh, nigga, hold on. Hey, bro, such and such just whoop, be on your P's and Q's. You didn't do none of that.
Man, that's why I keep telling these cats, man, I don't care what side you claim. Snake shit is snake shit. Rat shit is rat shit.
This episode is being sponsored by Desktop Lightning. The power of Desktop Lightning. Let's get into it. Instant traffic generation. Drive traffic effortlessly with your message broadcast, bypassing cluttered inboxes and spam filters. Visitors to your websites. All visitors you get are from real humans, not bot. All clicks you get are from real humans and not bot. Viral network. As you invite your downlines and they in turn invite their own downlines, your list will experience exponential growth through viral expansion. Earn residual income. You will earn up to 50% commissions for every paid sign up in your downlines. Fast results. Broadcast your message to thousands of hungry buyers with a single click. The message will appear on people's computers or mobile devices instantly. We have a special deal for viewers of RayGive TV. Use promo code RGTV to get the special discount, limited time offer only, free daily 1,000 advertising credits just for joining. Broadcast to thousands of hungry buyers with one click. So what are you waiting on? Join for free and send your ad within minutes. And we thank you, Desktop Lightning.
This real shit. Like, these niggas is, you know, niggas thought I was involved in this police ass program he had. Niggas had me whack. Ain't no way you that close to the nigga. Nigga, I ain't from no 60s, nigga. I ain't part of the development option in non-profit corp. The I'ma know, nigga. I know about Pop on the football, back to school giveaways and turkey giveaways and graffiti removal. Nigga, I ain't never seen no shit like this. He said, yeah, whack, we just dug into it. Your name ain't nowhere. I know it ain't nowhere on there. Nigga, I know nothing about this shit. Nigga, this shit crazy. Go to my neighborhood, nigga, and pull it up. Nigga, see if I'm would I'd have had him hook me up with my region, right? He said, yeah, whack, you ain't on there. And I know the fuck I ain't. It ain't never cool for no nigga from the streets to have a contract with the LAPD that stipulates we're going to give you a cell phone to call in all illegal gang and drug activity in your area, and we're going to pay you. As long as you produce, you continue to get paid. And after 3 years, you did such a good job, they doubled your pay.
It's Ray Give TV.
Up in the block.
From $5.50 to $9.95. Nah, nigga, that ain't cool. What no nigga say? That ain't cool.
Hold up. Drop a comment down below. Let me know what y'all think about the content so far. Whack and Big U ran for 17 years. So when he's speaking on him, he knows by personal experience. You know what I mean? Not just from hearsay or just knowing of somebody. Nah, he really knows him. So he knows the facts about what he is and what he ain't. You know what I mean? But what y'all think, let me know in the comments. It's your boy Ray Give. Let's get back to it.
Man, this is the same LAPD that fucking sick dogs are you in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, and 90s. Why the fuck would you want to team up with them?
Oh, shit. Hold on, bro. Hey, man, Google what time Nipsey was killed. Oh, all right. Shit, I didn't see that. What time? better not be no one something. I just realized what he sent me. It better not be 2 o'clock, I mean. That shit, but that better not be. This is scary now. I just saw that this nigga sent me. These niggas be mad. The other niggas, man, you know the nigga telling, but why gotta be the one to see the blood? Man, I wouldn't give a fuck what I am, nigga. We was on the yard, we gonna bring y'all niggas to work, y'all don't handle it, we gonna handle it, nigga, you know how it go. This is crazy.
Hey, Wack, look in the chat. Uptown Juice posted the link of the autopsy reveal.
Yeah, what time was he? This nigga just sent me some shit with the finger pointing at. I didn't even realize what he was saying.
He said the article said 3:55.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
No, did they pronounce him dead at 3:55 or was he shot at that time?
It looked like he was pronounced. Hold on.
They pronounced him dead at 3:55, Wack. I'm trying to find out what time.
That makes sense because
he was in the ER at 3:55. That's when they pronounced him.
Okay, so let me tell you why that, bro. I'm just show y'all a little clip. Yo, this is nasty work. I just realized, but I ain't realized the nigga sent me this shit. So that makes sense because if they pronounce him dead at 3:55, let me phase this shit out because I don't want to give his shit away. Let him have his little shock value. The nigga sent this. Now y'all could just kind of use y'all what this is, a screenshot of. The top of that is Big U, Big Ass Head. Yeah, I'm looking at what he sent me. And I'm wondering, why did he send me this? The time is 2:39. Now, this is the FaceTime. So, if he put down dead at 3:55, did he say this nigga called him and said he was dead? And when he called, he wasn't. But then 30 minutes later, he was dead. But that means 2:40. Let's put 30 minutes on that. 2:40, 3 o'clock, 3:10. And you saying he was in the emergency room at 3:55. So, that means he was shot right about 3:10. Shot, paramedics, police, get there. I cleared out by, yeah, it's lining up. Yeah, I'm like, why do you have a finger on it? What the fuck
is this?
Yeah, I'm like, why he got a finger pointing at the time? And I guess
older walks up and said, you thought me through. A quarter of a group of fire and pistol and one revolver, three.
If he at the hospital at 3:55, that 2:39.
The hospital says you threw a quarter of a witness and open fire and pistol. According to the article I'm about to post in the chat, Eric Holder shot him at 3:19 p.m.
Shot him at 3:19. That's why that makes sense. Listen, so 2:40, and then 20 minutes, 30 minutes. That means 3 o'clock, 3:10. So then that's right around the time he said, nigga, I called Nip and he was still alive. But then 30 minutes after I called him, nigga called me talking about he dead. This is why I'm like, that's why I was like, what the fuck is this nigga sending me? Why he got a finger pointing?
The article I just posted in the chat says, or they give a distinct timeline. at 2:51 p.m., Hustle arrives unannounced in the clothing store. Then at 3:04, a holder and a woman driving mostly aimlessly look for something to eat at 3:04. But Holder call all of it matters. But at 1:30 p.m., Holder calls a woman he's known for about a month to see if she want to eat. If she want to get together and get something to eat.
That's nasty word. That line up then.
Now, would they be recording that on California time?
Yeah, that's Cali time. Everybody in Cali. That shit. I was just looking. I didn't even see. I'm like, why the fuck is this nigga got a hand pointing at the fucking corner? And I looked. It was a time. Oh, that nigga in trouble. He got what he got. Big U, he not a smart dude. His memory fucked up too. He don't remember what he doing, what he done did, said. This is why I said they done told him, bro, stay off Clubhouse, bro. Cause you on there trying to clean some shit up and lie. And Wack is taking your voice and putting it to real audio visuals and paperwork, bro, and it ain't lining up. You looking crazy, bro. Keep him coming. I used to have to tell him the same shit, bro, when we go in the meeting. Just lay back. You know how many times I told them people, hey, he's got laryngitis, so don't expect him to do a lot of talking. Because he'd talk his way right out the deal. Dude is not a smart guy at all. I'm telling y'all, he's not intelligent like that. People just come to him because he had a name and they bring shit to him. And he would call people around him, your whack people. You know, they brought this to me. I don't know nothing about this shit. I know you got a team do it. Can you take the call for me? Real shit.
So, do you think BU...
R&B helped the nigga market that little TV show. They brought it to me for 18 months. I didn't want it. I said, go let Big U do it. They sent it to Big U. R&B help market that shit. R&B was on billboards in the middle of Times Square with him. He said every time we got on the phone, everybody talked about him. I said, I know, because he don't know what the fuck going on.
Do you think he was jealous of Nipsey because he was getting more respect in the hood than he was?
Nah, I just think he wanted to control Nip, and Nip wasn't going to let it happen. That's it. I told him not to even sign the nigga. I told the nigga, I said, hey, bro, I don't know, there's something about dude, bro. I'm telling you, right now, be a good sign. Whack man, do it. I said, look, I'm gonna do what you asked me to do. I'm just telling you as a brother, bro. I don't know, bro. I don't think it's gonna be a good thing for you. But if you want us to do the play, we'll do the play. But I'm warning you. Shit. We did the play, got the nigga signed, create the fake buzz that we wanted to sign him. And got the labels to push and getting to him before we did. Took the nigga on the tour, the fake shit. Signed him. That nigga went to New York. I said, bro, don't let that nigga go to New York with them people. That nigga went to New York, bring him 38 days in. He called that nigga Big U and said, man, I don't think your reputation fits my brand, and it's going to be bad for my brand. It's best we part ways. And then he went and did a song and dissed Big U. It's a song up called, what the fuck is that called? Song called Not You or some shit like that.
Yeah, you played it on.
Yeah, all you gotta do is pull it up, y'all. And when he did that nigga Big U went over there to that same lot. He got killed there and knocked Nipsey motherfucking ass out. Beat the shit out of Nipsey. They whooped him and all them niggas ass over there. I had to bail Big U out. Black Sam came out, shot the gun in there. He fresh on parole. Police cross the street. Come over there, arrest everybody.
Damn.
Yeah, it's a fact. Yeah, so that's what it was. I said, hey, nigga, I told you. Man, I said, I told you, bro. I told you, nigga. I tried to tell you. You wanna listen? You know what I'm saying? I tried to tell you to do your paperwork right. You didn't wanna listen. You just did the paperwork with your little 30%, you know, on the pub and all this shit. But you ain't got no say-so. They ain't got the that nigga go sign whatever deal he want to sign to without you. I told you, I tried to do your work. I warned you, nigga. You didn't want to listen.
That shit crazy, man.
I told him. Like, y'all don't understand. Like, nigga, that was my brother, nigga. Like, 17, 18. Man, listen, man. This is a fact.
I know. You done said that a lot.
You know, like, my nigga, they ain't talking about no, you know what I'm saying? That nigga, boy, that nigga come to my house like I went to his. This is real talk. I know this nigga inside. That's why they all telling him, like, bro, why is you trying to fight this nigga, bro? You know this was your brains behind a lot of shit. You know this nigga's great. And niggas say whatever they want about Wack. You ain't going to deny one thing. The nigga know his business. And nigga, he going to play it how you want to play it. Niggas got to use their brain. Big user gangster, okay? Let's give him that.
Right.
Let's just say he's that. You think he ran with that power roof for 17 years and he was soft? Is you niggas slow in the head? Like, is you niggas slow? You ain't never heard Big U say, oh, I was squeezing him, he was paying rent, he was paying. You ain't never heard a nigga say none of that shit about Wack. Do the fucking math. Is y'all that slow? A nigga like that is only gonna fuck with another type of nigga if he equivalent or stronger than what the fuck is going on with him. Or it don't make no sense to fuck with him. Unless he's a buster and he's extorting.
Shit, I wonder how many cats he told on that got his name in their paperwork.
Bro, this paperwork we just got back from 1991 is ugly. I ain't even lost a missile.
Damn, from 91.
Yeah, it's Brand Eddie Boy. I got it back. Nasty work. AKA in there and everything.
So how many is that?
He got, well, the ones we know about is the LAPD contracts, Eddie Boy, and then his little homie just called us, some nigga named Lil Thirst. Big U was telling him take a deal. They was offering him like 15, 20 years on the murder. Big U was telling him to take the deal. I don't even know this nigga. He called, hey homie, hey listen, you don't know me, this, that, and that. I'm from 6-0, I'ma call 600, but my nigga, the nigga was telling me to take a deal, he thought I took it, I didn't, I took it to the box, I got found guilty. See, when you take a deal, you don't never see who told on you, you don't see the paperwork, unless you go to the joint and file an appeal, and if they grant the appeal, then you'll get all the paperwork. This is why the BG paperwork just popped up. Because dude just got his appeal paperwork. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it was all in the appeal. He didn't see all that from the gate. Because he took a deal. Right? So when this nigga, whoever this nigga from Thirst is, this nigga Thirst from 60s, who Big U told to take a deal, didn't take the deal, he get his paperwork back. Big U and developing options and the whole program is all in his paperwork. They the ones identified.
You get all the discovery. You get everything.
You get everything. So he like, bro, this my motherfucking case number, all my shit. Go pull my shit, bro. I'm hearing you got the heart to expose this nigga. This nigga ain't right. So that was coming. Yeah. I mean, really, if I wouldn't have been the one exposed, nobody would have said nothing. They'd been too scared to say something.
Wack, but this shit need to be exposed, man. He telling on some, man, some real niggas.
Man, these niggas out here, man. I tell like ladies, go get you a square, nigga. Fuck these street niggas. These street niggas want to drive your car, play video games on your electric bill, all this shit. They broke. Go get you. Their teeth ain't right. Their credit ain't right. None of that. Man, fuck your couch up. That one little spot. Go get you a square, nigga. You know what I'm saying? He went to school. He got him a little job at the bank. He working his way up. Nigga work out. His hygiene is right. He ain't got his credit is right. Go get you a square, nigga. I'm telling you. I'm telling y'all. I'm telling y'all. Street niggas ain't it.
Yeah.
Hey, Wack, you ever sit back and think how many, like I am gonna call it exclusives, or how many drops you done put down and let niggas know since you've been on this app, like how many actual things that been exposed starting. I'm just thinking
about it. It been a gang of them though.
If somebody would cannibalize.
I say something to a nigga they don't believe, then it come up. I told y'all about finesse 2 times 6 months ago. Everybody thought I was crazy.
With the 10 niggas that wanted the 10 airplane tickets.
Yeah, I told niggas. I said, bro, the nigga told on 3 niggas. It ain't federal or state. Man, it's my bro. This is not a federal or state, bro. They didn't see it because he was a juvenile. He was like 16, 17. But the niggas he told on was adults. It's in their work. You ain't gonna see it in this federal work because federal work ain't gonna show it. Oh, okay. Now all the work that came out, the 3 niggas that got out of jail and then released all the work. I told niggas this 6-7 months ago.
Something else you said too to me. The reason why I said that, y'all was talking about something, and I'm gonna get to the point real quick. You always say the same thing on this app about this music shit. The music urban down, what, 50 or 60?
Drop a comment down below. Let me know what y'all think about the content, man. I appreciate the support. Everybody tuning in. Big U, Brick Baby, Rico and Diamonds, Developing Options. It's a lot to take in, man. I mean, they got a lot going on. These dudes keep mentioning Wack, and he's going, you know, do what he do. And there it go. I mean, what else is there? When somebody tries to cross another person, you know, they take that personal. And however they feeling is how they feeling. They gonna express that in whatever manner they see fit, right? So that's that. But my advice to the people, do what you gotta do to stay out of these sticky situations. Keep your best foot forward. Make the most of your 24 hours. Stay down until you come up. Let me repeat that. Stay down until you come up. You feel me? Nothing comes to a dreamer, though. You don't have to get up off your shoulders and go get to the bag. You feel me? Eat your Wheaties and get to it. Why not? What else is there? You feel me? I mean, you're going to have to make it somehow, some way. One way or another, right? So put some hustle behind that muscle and get to it. It'll be greater later. Apply yourself. Be proactive. Say no to drugs. Stay out the streets. Stay low. Keep your circle smaller than a dot. But shout out to the gang, man. I appreciate the support. It's your boy Ray Given. I'm gone. God bless.
Peace.
Thanks for watching another reaction video. I'm out.